Brandon House Cultural and Performing Arts Center.
Brandon House Cultural Center on Colonel Glenn.
Organizations like Brandon House through our community programs.
The Brandon House Cultural and Performance Center.
BH Productions looks like they're on the right track.
As I get to know the folks at Brandon House.
Brandon House is here to serve this community, to serve Little Rock, to serve Arkansas.
A lot of people often ask, how did we get the name Brandon House? Many Arkansans remember the former Brandon House furniture store on 12th and University. When my daughter, Dr. Patrice, who serves as our associate director, and my husband, Paul Bax, who's our director of finance, would drive down University, they would pass by the former Brandon House furniture building that had over 130,000 square feet of space, and they would dream of programs and services. When the Bax family walked into the building, it inspired us to want to do something in the way of arts for the community. After doing some extensive research, we found out that the schools were eliminating the arts, and shortly in April 2013, I contacted Ms. Sissy Riggs Brandon. I shared with her our vision for the former Brandon House building. Mrs. Sissy Brandon responded with an email, and she said that our idea of converting the former Brandon House furniture store into an active art and performance center is brilliant. She said that Little Rock had grown to the point that it would support such a center. She gave her blessing, so to speak, for us to use the name Brandon House in our name as a nonprofit organization. The former Brandon House furniture building, of course, was torn down due to asbestos in the building. But fast forward to today, we have created a state-of-the-art training facility that houses almost all of the creative spaces that Dr. Patrice and Mr. Bax envisioned in the former Brandon House furniture building. At Colonel Glenn Road, with over 16,000 square feet of space, we have created a state-of-the-art theater with staging and lighting and a sound booth room, a recording studio, an art gallery and art studio sponsored by Wingate Foundation, a state-of-the-art dance studio, music recording studio, BH production spaces that serves as our creative workforce development training model, our BH retail gift shop, the Artistic Corner Cafe that is home to small open mic and poetry performances, and spaces for arts education classes and workshop. The same vision that Dr. Patrice and Paul had in 2010 is what we have created. And 13 years later, students, creatives, musicians, and artists are taking advantage of that vision.
You know, Brandon House is really a phenomenal, I want to call it an institution, because I've been with it since it started from the ground up. I remember meeting at different people's offices or maybe at a hotel conference room, and it was just really a germ of an idea, but it was a great idea. And the idea was to provide education in the arts and in the media field for at-risk youth. And it was a concept that was really great. It wasn't an original concept, but it was a concept that really had a good foundation when I first started with the Baxes. And I just am so thrilled that it has grown from a germ of an idea to actually a sprout, into a plant, into a tree, into branches, and it just continues to grow.
I say Brandon House, they be like, oh my God, I've heard such and such. Like, I have never said I work for Brandon House, and someone be like, ugh, it's always positive. Always positive. Like, well, dang, yeah, they just did a function last week and my kid was there. Mm-hmm. Like, or they got something that's going, I heard, what about this and what about that? Like, all the time, you know what I mean? Because, like I say, Patrice gave me a thing of cards this long. For me, that's a mouthpiece, you know what I'm saying? Mm-hmm. That's a conversation starter. So here you go, hey, sir, do you know about such and such? You know what I'm saying?
I'm Paula Rogers, and I am currently retired 2 years as a program engagement manager from University of Arkansas at Little Rock and a program called Children International. And that's how I came involved with Brandon House. Actually, it wasn't even Brandon House then. It was Dr. Bax and Paul and Patrice at the time. And my manager took me to a Saturday meeting to meet this family who was developing this after-school enrichment program. And she was retiring, she didn't tell us. So she brought me along because she kind of knew this was going to be a good idea. And so I'm just grateful that she thought enough to bring me along. And we sat at a table on a Saturday afternoon in a hotel that's not even here anymore and watched and listened to this fabulous presentation from Patrice. She had just really laid it out digitally. She was on point on everything that she wanted to tell us about what their vision was. And wow, I was just so excited. So here I'm sitting at this table listening to this family talk about a dream that they had. They were from Chicago and I'm from Gary, Indiana, so I was really excited about the connection there, you know, like, okay, from Chicago, yeah. And so Paul was talking about he and Patrice would drive going to school. He would be taking her to school, or I think that's what they said, every day, and they would pass this building. It was a furniture store, and the furniture store was closed by now, but they'd gone out of business. But the name was still there, Brandon House. And, you know, they were just looking at this facility that, wow, what an opportunity, you know, for them if they could have this facility and they could do after school programming, they could do art programming. They were already looking at Dream Starters and doing iHustle. Those were programs that Patrice had already developed. She was working, going to school and working on those programs.
When I came through, the Boys Club was there. Mm-hmm. Well, the Boys Club won't work today. Yeah. And so we need to give students a voice. First off, you need to ask them what they're interested in, but nobody's asking. And so because nobody's asking, they're just doing stuff. And a lot of the stuff that they're doing is just not beneficial to them or to the community.
We have so much to look forward to and to be thankful for. Brandon House has grown, and I'm really excited about 2023. We got a lot in front of us, but I'm pretty sure that we can handle it. I want to say that I appreciate each and every one of you all. Staff, our little Dream Starters program, which is the number one.
Yeah.